Welcome to Classy Classics, where I take a look back at retro video games and see what exactly made them classics, rather than a forgotten pile of trash. And in today's episode, we're linking our show with the past. Oh, you love my puns, don't you? I'm just so punny. Oh ho ho. Now on today's episode, we'll be taking a look at one of the most beloved games in the Zelda franchise, A Link to the Past. But what exactly kept this beautiful masterpiece of cosmic proportions out of the garbage dump? Well, let's just take a look and find out for ourselves.
Link to the Past was originally released on November 21st, 1991 for the Super Famicom in Japan, and was instantly a must-buy, giving itself a North American release half a year later. But what made the game such a success? Was it the fancy graphics, the gameplay, the story, or the beautiful music? Well, I think you may all know it was all of the above. Link to the Past put just the right amount of effort into each aspect of the game, not letting one feel less than the other. Game mechanics were adjusted perfectly for near-perfect gameplay where you never felt cheated. Hitboxes are spot on and never feel like your sword is not dealing damage when it should. And speaking of the sword, the arc of the swing is perfectly designed to allow you to attack enemies while not putting yourself in danger, saving yourself some life instead of attacking a foe straight on.
The difficulty is also perfect, with a super nice learning curve keeping you at level with the enemies, but still allowing enough space for challenge, keeping the game fun and entertaining.
The visuals have to be some of the best I have seen in any SNES game. The color palette they use just matched so well, and all the colors flow and coincide with each other. It's like a masterpiece of art. And then when you add the beautiful composed music on top of that, everything just starts to glow with beauty.
You can really tell that Nintendo put all their love into this game just by looking at it and listening to it. It's something that really needs to be appreciated by more people, including this generation of youngsters.
The dungeons are so well designed with multiple fun and challenging puzzles that keep your brain thinking, and added onto that is one beautiful story that isn't too intrusive on the gameplay, but keeps you wondering about the history of the land you are in. And just like Majora's Mask, most of the non-playable characters have their own personalities that you can really enjoy and really consume yourself into.
With plenty of secrets and extra side quests, Link to the Past kept kids busy for hours on end in a beautifully immersive environment that kept them coming back for more. Visually, narratively, mechanically, and musically, this game was designed with a perfect formula for an enjoyable and fun gaming experience. And that right there is why this game is a classy classic.